Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. I hope you are doing okay. In today's video, I'm going to talk about a new project. It's called Pyramid Flow. And this project is a text to video project, which means that you can type in a text, it will generate a video. Now, as you can see on the screen, I have the Hugging Face page, and it tells us that it uses a training efficient autoregressive video generation method that is based on the flow matching. And the training data set that was used for this project is completely open source, which makes this project open source as well. Now I'm going to talk about the license a little bit later on, but from the description, you can see that it can generate, well, I'm quoting here, high quality 10 second video at 768p, 24 frames per second. And we have a couple of examples below. Now let's take a look at some of the examples. So you can see this one is 10 seconds long and I can play it. Yes, that's about 10 seconds. So I'm going to play it back, and this time I'm going to point towards a few things that I've noticed. So first, let's take a look at the face. You can see the eyelashes here and then the nose. Take a close look at the eyelashes and maybe go back and play it again. You will see that it slowly transforms into what we see here. Now this is going to be something that you will see in the other examples too. So here's another example. This time it's only 5 seconds long. And if you take a look at the eyes or even the helmet, you will see that there are a little bit of fluctuation that we can see. Now there's a third example, and this one is supposed to be some kind of painting where people would be walking around, and you can see that it's not really great, especially these two people here. The fact that this project is open source and it uses the open source data sets means that somebody else can take the same project, the same code, train it further, and we can see improvements in the future. Now you can follow everything that's going to happen under the news section, and you can see that the training code and a new model checkpoint will be coming soon. Now let's talk about the license. So this one is under the Stability AI community license. And at the top here, we have a section that talks about what you can do with it. So the agreement here is intended for research, non-commercial, as well as a limited commercial use of the model, which is free of charge. Now this limited commercial use is for people who are making an annual revenue of less than $1 million, which should be for, I guess, 95 or 99% of people using it. And remember that this license is for the model. When it comes to the actual code itself, the code is under MIT license, which means you can do anything that you want with the code itself. So that's why I said that we will be seeing some improvements in the future. Anyone can take the code, use it, train their own model, and hopefully that model will stay open source. Okay, so if you would like to give this project a try, there is a Hugging Face space. Of course, I'm going to leave the links in the description below. Once you reach this page, you will see that there is the image to video support. The main thing would be the prompt here, and then we have some additional settings below. Now, because this is running on Hugging Face, there is a cap. Right now, you will only be able to generate images for 8 frames and for 3 seconds. So the total number of images would be 24, which gets combined into a video. And you basically get a video of 3 seconds at 8 frames per second, at least for this Hugging Face demo. So let's take an example below. I'm just going to click on second one, and you can see it got generated here. I'm going to play it, and of course it's only 3 seconds, and this one is the 8 frames per second, not the full 24 one that we saw previously. But you can see that there are a few glitches, as you would expect when it comes to text to video. So right now, I don't think it's ready to be used in production, especially when it comes to big film industries. That's mostly where these type of project will be used to generate backgrounds and just make things moved. Right now, it's a little bit inconsistent, especially like for this one, the vehicle, you can see it sort of morph into a different kind. I'm not sure what is happening with this person here, but I'm going to keep an eye on this project and see, hopefully we get a new version, especially when it says here that there will be a new model checkpoints that is coming soon. All right, so that is it for today. Hopefully you got something out of this video. I'm going to keep an eye on this project. I think it is interesting and we can hope to get some improvements in the future. All right then, thank you for watching until the very end. Have a nice day, take care, and I will see you in the next one.